Hello. So, on May 17th of this year, 2023, the Catholic News Agency released an article about, this is the headline, non-binary characters in kids' Transformers show raise concern and backlash. Okay, I did not actively look for this. I just got a note for this, and I don't know why, like, when I saw it, I thought it was so absurd that I actually had tweeted. Which I'll leave the screenshot here. Anyways, I thought I would start by reading the article by Tyler Arnold, Washington DC, Newsroom, May 17th, 2023, 10:06 a.m. I don't know why we need to include the time, but okay. A new Transformers show, which is rated for children ages 7 or older, has faced some backlash and concerns for pressing gender ideology on children through the introduction of non-binary characters who identify as neither male nor female. Transformers Earthspark, which is an animated series that debuted on Paramount Plus and Nickelodeon last November, introduced a new non-binary Transformer named Nightshade, who uses they-them pronouns, and a human character named Sam, who uses she-they pronouns according to clips from the show. I know I'm safe when I'm with my friends or other non-binary people, Sam says in one of the clips. Afterwards, Nightshade questions the meaning of the term non-binary. People who aren't female or male, Sam responds. Nightshade further promotes the concept of a non-binary identity. I always knew my pronouns felt fine, but what a wonderful word for a wonderful experience. When Nightshade meets new characters throughout the show, the Transformer often includes the preferred pronouns in introductions. Okay, I will point out what's wrong with this, like, after, but I just want to read it first. At one point, when the long-running character Optimus Prime pauses before referring to Nightshade using a pronoun, another character steps into town. Nightshade's pronouns are they, them, to which Nightshade replies, he or she just doesn't fit who I am. Transformers are machines that do not have any biological anatomy, there we go, but have always been gendered as either male or female throughout the franchise's nearly 40-year-long history. Mary Weiss Hassan, the director of the Person and Identity Project at the Ethics and Public Policy Center, told CNA, which is Catholic News Agency, that parents need to shield their children from this type of material. Parents need to face the sad truth that there are no safe secular cartoons for kids anymore. Hassan said, Hollywood has a radical, damaging agenda, and parents need to shield their children from it. Hassan added that these themes deceive children about the reality of gender. Instead of entertaining children, these cartoons have a very adult and deeply deceptive message. The cartoon presents a non-binary character, non-binary isn't it, apostrophes, it's not quote, it's apostrophes. The cartoon presents a non-binary character who explains his identity as people who aren't male or female, a nonsensical, flat-up type of idea. Hassan said, every person is either male or female. To suggest otherwise is to lie to children about a fundamental truth. The inclusion of non-binary characters was also criticized by Ollie London. Oh, I heard about this one. I missed this one skimming. That's a source. That's really exciting. Okay, I'm gonna skip. I'm debating whether to skip anything Ollie London has to say because I think I heard about him. Or them. I'm gonna check to make sure. Okay, so the rest of the article is pretty much a quote, just Ollie London, which I did kind of do some research on before any of this. And I'm not going to honestly give him a platform. I just don't want to say anything he has to say because I just don't. I heard this pretty much everything specifically Ali London has done. I don't want to give him a platform. Fairly transphobic and all that. I just, no. But yeah, the last thing I will say, which is in the article, but not a quote, not anything from Ali London, is this is part of a growing trend in which transgender or non-binary characters are being added to television shows aimed at young children. In 2021, Blue's Clues, which is made for children ages 3 to 5, created a video with a drag queen singing about a gay pride parade. Oh no! Hide the children! In the same year, The Muppets, which is also made for young children, depicted cross-dressing by having the Muppet named Gonzo wear a princess gown to a ball. Okay, I don't know. You've probably seen the same different Muppets, but from what I've seen, I don't know how much of it's very child-friendly, but go on. But, yeah, that's the article. I'll leave it in the description, but I'm not saying any of Ali London's things. Nope. The person already has their own sort of thing, I don't want to be involved. There. I thought I would just point out some things. I thought Anode, when I was reading the comics, was trans, because that's what I perceived, but I was wrong. She's not trans, but she met RC in, this is in the 2005 IDW continuity, and apparently RC is a trans woman, which that caught me off guard. But the quote from Tia Fricky is, Anode once encountered a particular fellow trans woman, RC. That's a direct quote from Tia Fricky. So I could be wrong, but maybe Anode is trans, but I'm going to let you all interpret that, because I feel like I'm misinterpreting that, but yeah. And the other sort of queer thing that has happened, all these are like in the comics I found, so, which you can tell that the people writing the article clearly did not read the comics at all. Like, I was able to find all these in like 10 seconds. So, yeah, and there's a bee outside my window, so that's why I was looking. But anyways, in the 2019 IDW continuity, Breakdown and Knockout Share a Kiss. The quote is, on the day of the race, Knockout attended the opening ceremonies and later shared a kiss with Breakdown before the race began, which a photo of the kiss is in the wiki page, and I've seen it. Happy for them. But there's also another sort of queer relationship, which is Rewind and Chromedome, which I keep thinking it's Chromedome. I don't know why. My brain does that. I don't know why. But anyways, on the wiki, it says last slide, but it is more sort of sewn in issue 16 of More Than Meets the Eye, which is called The Gloaming. And the quote is that Brainstorm played with Chromedome not to do it again and honor Rewind by remembering him. He passed on a final message from Rewind, a memory stick delivered by two to the cell door as it was closing. These final words, an expression of love from Rewind, were enough to stop Chromedome from injecting and convincing Chromedome from injecting and convince him to hold on to the memory of his lost love. Like, they're both male characters. At least that's what I perceive them as when I was reading, when I was skimming the comics. The next one I want to mention is Tailgate and Cyclonus, which in the Last Light issue 18, which is The Everlasting Voices, You Are Here. Everlasting Voices, You Are Here, it's one thing. And the quote is, after Watermiss and crew shut down the clinic system, Cyclonus declared his love for Tailgate. Tailgate embraced him and told him to protect him as the constructs faded. And just, there's a panel that where they show like their love for each other, which I still think I have the screenshots for, which I will probably insert here. And I'll probably insert the screenshot for Rewind Chromedome's one prior and as well as Knockouts. So if there's weird cuts, that's why. That's why basically. But yeah, I definitely cried when like Cyclonus professes them, like honestly, like, oh my god, and the details though, the details. I appreciate that, said, honestly. So I've been debating mentioning Ratchet, which is Drift and Ratchet, because I didn't know if they were an actual sort of ship or just a fling or like a situation ship. I didn't know the specifics. But anyways, Ratchet in the 2005 IDW continuity said, and the quote from that is, in his time aboard the Madcap ship, Ratchet would form a grudging respect for the Decepticon town called Drift, eventually leading the ship to find the exiled bot, forming a strong bond with them once they are reunited. In time, this evolved into a full-blown romance, the two becoming Conjurers and Door, which, non-Transformers fans, Conjurers and Door is basically, it's basically male, it's like significant others, all that, basically. The two becoming Conjurers and Door before, far in the future, Ratchet experienced age-related burnout and passed peacefully, knowing he found love, something bigger than himself. I was wondering if they were, like, an actual thing, but I did not expect, like, the last line, but, like, yeah. So why am I showing these examples to you? I'm showing these basically to show that all of the queer stuff that all of these people are claiming from the show that is new or, like, recently developing, like, in the Transformers franchise is not. Literally, like, it's in the comics and probably in maybe minor stuff in other Transformers shows. I don't know. I haven't seen all of them, but that queerness has basically always been in the Transformers franchise, whether people like it or not. And also, these robots who have feelings is literally a quote in Transformers Prime when three civilian children, by the way, literally like get wrapped up in all of this and say, they're robots with feelings, with emotions. They literally say that. So, like, and I just think that the outrage over this is honestly overblown and really dumb, personally. But, yeah. But also, I want to talk about some things that I feel like are way worse than pronouns and stuff being mentioned in the Transformers franchise. Oh, because I can name a few off the top of my head. So I just want to rattle off some things that have happened within just Transformers that are worse than pronouns. In general, this just, I feel like in whatever continuity, there's various amounts of just possession and just torture via electrocution, I feel like. Like, it randomly happens throughout the shows, but I feel like they're all pretty much there one way or another. But specifically in the comics, the main one I can think of is a gas chamber sort of deal, which I don't know what specifically the issue is, but the screenshot I have, the line is, forget the generators, you should fix the air conditioning, talk about hot. Which I'll put the screenshot here that I'm referring to. And then also in Transformers Prime, there's the cortical psychic pads, which is used to basically get into Cybertronians' minds, which I think you can understand how messed up that would be in a villain's sort of hands. Hello, so editor Susan here again. I've been debating whether to add Silas from Transformers Prime to this sort of list because he does basically commit acts of domestic terrorism by trying to start like a new world order and like extensively learning Cybertronian biology to like basically create his own sort of Transformers and stuff, which is borderline terrorism, I feel like, and he assaults, like, Fowler and, like, destroys sort of government property, so, like,
isn't that technically like domestic terrorism, I feel like? Which I'm not surprised that, you know, the conservatives and like whites would, white sort of side would be okay with that. If you live in the US, you know what I'm talking about. But if not, you're probably confused. So, yeah. I don't know whether to add that, but like, that did happen in the show. So, yeah.
And then the one I can think of for seeds, besides torch and electrocution, is that basically Jetfire mentions that when he like sort of flips to like work with the Arbots, he says basically that if it helps to basically use a technique to blow up his head if he's out of line, which Seige is a fairly darker show from fairly does not feel right, I know, but like it's darker compared to the other Transformers shows from what I've seen. I've only seen one season, so
hello, so post-production kind of Susan here. I forgot to mention that in Seeds, Season 1, there was literally a scene where a character gets thrown onto spikes. I don't know if that's shown or if that's simply implied, but I remember that being there, so just wanted to include that because I forgot and just remembered.
But yeah, that's pretty much the main ones I can think of off the top of my head. The other without a doubt probably was and more I've missed, but yeah, don't let the whole pronoun are the worst thing in Transformers thing for you. No. There's literally worse. Literally more traumatizing things. Like that's cute in comparison in my opinion, but anyways. I just wanted to talk about that. And just yeah. All my links and like sources that I've used and so I've talked about this was will be in the description. I'll probably have sources for the ones I didn't like vocally say like the sources are and here. They're in the description too, so yeah. I hope that was interesting. Have a good summer and just stay. This is honestly kind of a lot, but yeah. Change rights.